I guess I'm through. I'm using this other video cam. My little I have this one little Linux box, and it's a 1604 upgrade of Ubuntu, and it went to BusyBox. So something happened. That means the init, whatever you call it, error. So because that happened, there's nothing you can do. You run the fsck command, then your slash dev slash whatever OS it is, and then whatever OS number, like your SD, blah blah. And then it starts to clear out all those orphans. So I had a whole bunch of orphans. Yeah, so something that's really odd, because I have barely used the machine, and yet it ran through to those. So, and I did set up one of the UFW firewalls, and it's almost like it's worse. It's worse, because it just dropped it out. And I hadn't even been doing anything. It was just contacting the internet a few times. So it could even be something that's in sync with the internet company itself, that it's sending out something that is, demands a reset. And when it doesn't get the reset, maybe it killed my little Ubuntu. So it was pretty kind of terrible, because it's a 1604, and I'm like, oh gosh, we're supposed to get higher upgrade, whatever. Anyway, I did have yet again another upgrade to the Google Sticks, since I'm in this Google pandemonium moment. The Google Sticks is, we can add little clothes, put clothes on the USB sticks. Now, make little characters, dress them up, and make them fun. And make the sticks forever sticks, that anytime you put them back into your computer and you're online, that whatever gigabytes of data, it'll run through any change through. So there's any change in those pages, it'll just run a quick update, and then that's that. So that'll be like, if we make the forever sticks and then make them have in sync, so you can sync them through, and then that'll be yay happy. So at least you'll be having not the throwaway recycle problem with the USB stick. You'll have have that little forever stick, and then that'll be something that you can just have as long as it works, as long as it keeps working. I don't know what about forever stick failure, but yeah, I'm having read-only problems also with Ubuntu, so yeah, we'll have to try to make sure read-only doesn't occur, because those are kind of yucky to fix, and I don't really want to right now. But so yeah, if with the wiki sticks, the Google sticks, an Amazon stick also, so there would be three of them, and you can start selling them around Christmas for $50 or $20 each, and then it's a forever stick that you can actually use in sync, so when you're without internet access for some reason, or you don't want to be online, you just are tired of the wiffy wave headed in through your bedroom, you can use those instead to surf around, and it will be the top pages. And I've mentioned this before. I mentioned this about, I don't know, I went back and it was 2012, so 4 years passed since this time, so it's kind of odd. Anyway, because it is an easy little an inclusion for these three major companies. It's an easy inclusion, an easy profit. So I'm not really sure why you all aren't jumping at it. So, yeah. And like I said, like little characters, if we can make, not sewn in any sweatshops around the world, but yeah, little tiny characters that with little eyeballs that you put on the USBs, So little tiny characters, and then we can, you can even sell those. You can, you know, market it through the, as everybody likes that in their cereal. You can even get the character clothing through your box of cereal, so we can really go commercial, and that will be fun. You know, your little box of Wheaties, you get the little character that you can add to your wiki stick, you know, and you can get like you could be 10 or 12 characters, or, you know, you can keep going with it. And so they can be like those collectibles that we've had collectibles through the years, you know, those little Steiffs. We've had all kinds of little toys, cabbage patch dolls, whatever, but these would be the little characters that you put on your forever sticks. And I know they're not going to last forever, but it's the point that it's a $20 spend that is not going to be a laborious one that you have to repeat next year or the year after. It's just going to be one that's an in sync. So it'll go around and do any of those updates. Any of those pages that have had, you know, what do you call that? A change, page change. Last date modifies and all of that. So you'll seek out for those, grab them out, and then you get fresh. So you get fresh data on your Google Sticks. And I don't know, maybe it's a cruddy name, Google Sticks or Forever Sticks. I don't know what else to come up with. But it does become a marketing fun product. You can even see them as little cowboys themselves, you know, roasting hot dogs around a campfire. Making them animated, making the Google Sticks animated so they walk around, even have their own cartoon show. It's Google Sticks in the morning, you know, whatever. But all of this. And then I didn't mention Yahoo, but obviously Yahoo can also have a Yahoo stick. So I would like that for the major companies to have some kind of a... Because we get tired of Google because it's just the search pages, and then there's the search pages, you know, to their favorite pages. So we would have the favorite pages, you know, not their whole sites, but much of their favorite pages, and then so you can have that search power, which is great. So when you, like, let's say you need the number for your bank, and you don't have it, it'll be there on your Google stick. You'll just go, oh my gosh, give me my number for my bank, give me my number for this, you know. So it'll help that seam of being online and offline. When we're like, I didn't write down the internet, I'm sorry, I just forgot to write down the entire internet, so I can't contact, you know. A lot of us are having directory disorder issues with our telephones, because you can't even call out on the telephone anymore. Really. That would help that gap of communication moment. So I guess that's where I'm at right now. Now we like Yahoo, and I'll tell you why we like Yahoo is because it does have the news channel right there. It has that fresh news channel, and then it also has access to your own My Yahoo. And so that could be something. That's not really something on a Google stick, though, that you're gonna necessarily get updated fresh, but you can still go through and read the Yahoo pages. So that would be fun, because Yahoo has a lot of, we call it a popular. They're like these. Sometimes they're buoyancy relief. Like, I'm feeling like, oh my gosh, look at that dress on that woman. That's ridiculous. You know, sometimes it's just a buoyancy relief site, and I just love it. So, thank you, Yahoo, for that. And maybe that's all they've become, but maybe they're just the most necessary to be a buoyancy relief website. Okay, so, I'll stop this and upload it, because it's really just about the productivity of those particular products and boosting them out there. You've got to get them out there.